Welcome to the Folktale Project. This is Dan Shawls. Today we have another story of Christmas time and Santa Claus, and this is again from a budget of Christmas tales, a collection that has some very interesting stories. This one in particular, chronicling, an older brother's attempt to pull a fast one on his younger sibling. This is Billy's Santa Claus Experience by Cornelia Redmond. Of course, I don't believe in any such person as Santa Claus, but Tommy does. Tommy is my little brother, age 6. Last Christmas, I thought I'd make some fun for the young one by playing Santa Claus, but as always happens when I try to amuse anybody, I just got myself into trouble. I went to bed pretty early on Christmas Eve so as to give my parents a chance to get the presents out of Mama's room, where they had been locked up since they were bought. I kept my clothes on except my shoes and put my nightgown over them so as to look white if any of them came near me. Then I waited, pinching myself to keep awake. After a while, Papa came into the room with a lot of things that he'd dumped on Tommy's bed. Then Mama came in and put some things on mine and in our 2 stockings that were hung up by the chimney. Then they both went out very quiet, and soon all the lights went out too. I kept on pinching myself and waiting for a time, and then, when I was sure that everybody was asleep, I got up. The first thing I went into was my sister's room, and got her white fur rug that Mama gave her on her birthday, and her sealskin cape that was hanging on the closet door. I tied the cape on my head with shoestrings and made a good big cap. Then I put the fur rug around me and pinned it with big safety pins that I found on Tommy's garters. Then I got Mama's new scrap basket trimmed into roses, which Mrs. Simmons broidered for the church fair, and piled all the kids' toys into it. I fastened it to my back with Papa's suspenders, and then I started for the roof. I hurt my fingers some opening the scuttle, but kept right on. It was snowing hard, and I stood and let myself get pretty well covered with flakes. Then I crawled over to the chimney that went down into our room, and climbed up on top of it. I had brought my bicycle lantern with me, and I lighted it so as to Tommy could see me when I came down the chimney into the room. There did not seem to be any places inside the chimney where I could get hold on by my feet, but the ceiling in our room was not very high, and I had often jumped most as far, so I just let her go, and I suppose I went down. Anyway, I did not know anything for a long time. Then I woke up all in the dark with my head feeling queer, and when I tried to turn over in bed, I found I wasn't in bed at all. And then my arms and legs began to hurt terrible, mostly one arm that was doubled up. I tried to get up, but I couldn't because my bones hurt so, and I was terrible cold, and there was nothing to stand on. I was just stuck. Then I began to cry, and pretty soon I heard Mama's voice saying to Papa, "Those must be sparrows that are making that noise in the chimney. Just touch a match to the wood in the boys' fireplace." I heard Papa strike a light, and then the wood began to crackle. Then, by jinx, it began to get hot and smoky, and I screamed, "Help! Murder! Put out that fire unless you want to burn me up!" Then I heard Papa stamping on the wood, and Mama calling out, "Where's Billy? Where's my child?" Next, Tommy woke up and began to cry, and everything was terrible, especially all the pains all over me. Then Papa called out very stern, "William, if you are in that chimney, come down at once." And I answered crying that I would if I could, but I was stuck and couldn't. Then I heard Papa getting dressed, and pretty soon he and John from the stable went up on the roof and let down ropes what I put around me, and they hauled me up. It was just daylight, and I was all black and sooty and scratched, and my arm was broken. Everybody scolded me except Mama. I'd spoiled my sister's white rug and broken all of Tommy's toys, and the snow what went in through the scuttle melted and marked the parlor ceiling. Besides, I guess it cost Papa a good deal to get my arm mended. Nobody would believe me that I had just meant to make some fun for Tommy, and my arm and all my bruised places hurt me awful for a long time. If I live to be a million, I am never going to play Santa Claus again. And that is Billy's Santa Claus Experience. A young troublemaker trying to just make a little bit of fun for his younger siblings. This is Dan Shawls for the Folktale Project. Don't forget that you can subscribe to the podcast on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, anywhere that you like to get your podcasts. You can follow us on Instagram and Threads at Folktale Project. If you'd like to help support the project, you can head over to patreon.com/folktaleproject. Or you could always just share with the stories with someone you love. I do appreciate that. As always, thank you so much for listening.